HISD isn't going down without a fight. Find out what they're doing to stop the TEA takeover. George Zimmerman is filing a lawsuit against Trayvon Martin's family. And why your perm could lead to breast cancer. The story's coming up.
Hi, I'm Rashonda Tate Billingsley with your weekly Defender News Wrap, where we bring you the biggest news stories from the Black community.
HISD isn't allowing the TEA takeover without a fight. Remember, TEA ruled HISD had failed at governing itself, but in a last-ditch effort to prevent a state takeover, lawyers for the district implored a federal judge to stop the takeover until he rules on the merits of a lawsuit challenging the action in general. Attorneys for HISD say the TEA commissioner exceeded his authority at nearly every step as he moved to appoint a board of managers to lead HISD, a decision they said would disenfranchise voters of color. The judge didn't rule from the bench, but said he'd issue a written opinion as soon as possible. Drastic cuts are coming to people who use food stamps, compliments of the Trump administration. 700,000 people nationwide, about 1 in 10 Texas households, that receive food stamps could lose their eligibility if a newly proposed federal regulation is implemented. Right now, a family of four can only make $42,000 a year to get food stamps. With the new rule, that same family can't make more than $33,000 a year. Oh, and if they own a car, their car can't be worth more than $15,000. Currently, under the new proposal, that value would drop to $4,600. There they go, making America great again. And then you're not going to believe this news? George Zimmerman is suing Trayvon Martin's family, their attorney, and others for $100 million. Yes, the same George Zimmerman that killed Trayvon Martin. I wish I was making this up. The wannabe cop claims he was the victim of a conspiracy, along with malicious prosecution and defamation. Basically, dude is broke and trying to swindle cash from the people he hurt. Martin's family simply said there's no evidence to support this claim. What started out as the most diverse field of Democratic presidential candidates in history is quickly becoming a glaringly white one. The departure of Senator Kamala Harris, the only Black woman in the race, leaves six candidates, all white, who have qualified for the next debate scheduled for December 19. The other people of color left in the race, Cory Booker, Tulsi Gabbard, Julian Castro, Andrew Yang, and Deval Patrick, have not yet qualified for the debate. We've known that Black women face higher risks of breast cancer, but now research shows that the use of chemical hair products increases Black women's risk for cancer even more. According to a new study, Black women who regularly use permanent dyes had a 60% increased risk of breast cancer as compared with an 8% increased risk for white women. The study also found women who regularly relax their hair were about 30% more likely to develop breast cancer. While the case for going natural continues. And finally, if you haven't already voted, we hope you will head to the polls on Saturday the 14th and pick up this week's copy of The Defender to find out who's on the ballot. Here's a little help planning your weekend. On Wednesday, December 11th, the HMAAC will have champagne and ribs. On Saturday, December 14th, Faith in Action will have Operation Love Toy and clothing giveaway. Also that day, Shape will have their annual holiday brunch. Check them out, and if you have some events you'd like to share, send to us at news@defendermediagroup.com.
It's a wrap. Make sure you're following us at Defender Network on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And join us here next week for all your Defender highlights.